Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about disk structure in the computer system. That is the topic of operating system, and in this basically we will be discussing about the physical structure of the disk and logical structure of the disk. If you talk about disk, it is the secondary storage structure that we use to store the data permanently in the system. That is, it can be hard disk, it can be other external storage devices that are used to store the data permanently. But we will specifically be discussing about the structure of the disk that is permanently connected to your system, and that is known as hard disk drive. So we will study about the hard disk drive's physical structure and the logical structure, that how data is being implemented and stored in the hard disk. So let's proceed. So this is basically the outline of the content that we are going to discuss: storage and mobile technologies, disk structure, physical structure, and the logical structure. And after the end of the video, you will be able to learn about the basics of disk structures and how the actual information is stored within the disk. You will get to know about that. So first we talk about disk. Basically, disk is the secondary storage structure device that is used to actually store the data in your computer system permanently. It provides a means to store large amount of information into the computer systems in today's world. That means because today we are dealing with the huge amount of data, and that data needs to be stored in a particular area that can be accessed as and when required by the user or the system. For example, hard disk, floppy disk, CD drives, DVD drives, Blu-ray disk, etc. So these are various storage technologies that we use for storage of the data from the ancient time to the modern time. In the earlier stage, we were using floppy drives. Then we move forward to zip drives. Then we came to the usage of tape drives, that is magnetic tapes. Then we move forward to the pen drive usage, that is USB pen specifically. Then we move to CD, DVD drives, optical drives that we can see. And then we are actually using the hard disk drives, that is the permanent storage connected to your system and always remains active when the system is switched on. So let's move forward to the disk structure. Actually, the structure of disk, as you all know, it is a circular platter that is used to store the data, and that particular platter or the circular plate is divided into tracks, cylinders, and sectors. Hard disk drives are organized as a concentric stack of disks. That means one disk is situated on the other and a third one on that one. That means a complete stack of the disk situated on one another, which cumulatively forms the size of the disk to store the data. Each disk or the platter has two surfaces and two read-write heads. Read-write heads are basically the tools or the components that are used to read data from the hard disk and to write data to the hard disk on a particular location. For that, we use read-write heads. So every platter in the hard disk has two read-write heads, because there are two surfaces and each surface will require a dedicated read-write head to read data on that particular surface. each platter in the disc will be having the same number of tracks. That means if suppose in the disc there are 10 platters, then all the platters will be of same capacity, of same size, will be having the same number of tracks. Platter is made up of aluminium, ceramic or glass. This is the material that is used to make the platter, the disc. And that material is coated with the magnetic materials such as iron oxide that is actually used to store the data in your disc platter. This is the exploded view of the hard disk drive. In this is the platter that we are talking about, that is the circular plate actually used to store the data. Might be you all have seen this in the real world. You also use them for stories of the songs or movies or videos that are available in the market. Then second one is read write heads. This is the read write head that is situated on the surface of the platter, on the top and the bottom side, that means on both the surfaces of the disc, and all the disc platters has the read write heads for their usage. This is the spindle that is shown at the third point. This is the center core arm on which the platters are situated. This is the actuator. Actuator is basically a tool that is used to move the read write heads over the surface of the platter to access the particular location of data. If you are reading, or to access a particular location to store the data, the location that is free for storage. For that we need to move the read write heads, and for that actuators are used. Then comes housing. Housing is basically the base assembly or the base of the all the components of the drive on which the components are situated. Then comes power connector. These are the power connectors that are used to provide power supply to all the components of the disk. And the last one is the base module that is called PCB, printed circuit board, on which all the components are embedded. All the circuitry is there to perform all the functions of the disk. This is the internal detailed view of a hard disk drive. Then we discuss about the disk geometry. That means the structure, how the structure is divided, what are the different components of the structure of a particular platter. So in the disk structure geometry, first one is the platter, that is the actual disk that is used to store the data or records. So these are like in the older times about the phonographs records that were used to play the songs or the entertainment content in an old-fashioned jukebox. Multiple platters, as you have seen, multiplaters are used in the hard disk drive to increase the capacity of storage in the drive. As the number of platters increase, the capacity of the hard drive increases. Then comes heads. Each platter is associated with a read-write head on each surface. They are actually the energy converters. That is, they transform electrical signals into magnetic signals in the magnetic data, in the magnetic form. And if you are writing a data, that means when the computer sends some data to store on the hard disk, then electrical signals are being sent, and these heads then convert these electrical signals back to the magnetic signals, because the material that is used to store the data is magnetic, like iron oxide. So for that, magnetic field is needed to be created, and for that electrical signals are converted into magnetic signals, and then data is written onto the disk. And if you are reading a data from the hard disk, then reverse process is performed. That is, magnetic signals are converted back into the electrical signals and data is obtained from the disk. Then comes tracks. Tracks are basically the circular areas of the disk. Just like you, if you have studied software engineering, in that spiral model is there. Like that, the circular structures are there on the platter. These structure circular areas are called as the tracks. The length of a track is one circumference of the disk. Over 1000 tracks are available on a hard disk. Approximately, that depends, that varies from the size of the hard disk, size to size it varies. Also, the data first written to the outermost track, that means the first track that is available on the disk is the outermost track, and it is first used to store the data. Then comes sectors. These circular tracks are then further divided into subparts. These subparts are known as sectors. Cylinders. This is the logical grouping of same track on each platter, because as you know, the platters are situated on one another as a stack. So if we talk about the vertical structure of the disk, then the same track on every platter, and we connect those tracks logically, then that becomes a cylinder like structure. So that is called cylinder, a combination of the same track on every disk surface. So basically, this is the combination of all the tracks with same radius on every platter of the disk, and that is known as a cylinder. Then comes clusters. Cluster is basically a combination of multiple sectors on the disk. That means several sectors form a cluster. Generally, one cluster is of 64 sectors. And these are the clusters basically are used by the operating system to store the data that is used to access the basic general logical information of the disk structure. So this is basically a platter. That is, as you can see in the diagram, the circular area is shown. The complete circular area in 360 degree is a track, and each track is divided into further subparts from vertical lines. These parts are known as the sectors. These are the different platters situated on one another, stacked over one another. 1, 2, 3 platters are shown. So platter is actually a round magnetic plate that constitutes part of a hard disk. Hard drives can contain a dozen of platters mounted on the same spindle. Spindle is the core root through which arm of the disk is connected, and which rotates the disks to read the data. Platters require two read-write heads, one for each side, as we have already discussed this, and therefore can store information on both sides. This is actually the cylinder. The cylinder that is shown through the dotted lines on all the platters, this complete is a cylindrical structure. This is the cylinder which comprises of the multiple sectors of different, multiple tracks of different platters, of all the platters available on the disk. So these are the tracks, the circular areas on the disk. These are shown. The outermost track that is shown with the purple color is the track 0, the first track. then yellow track is on the second track, and when you move inwards, that track number is increasing. That is, that means the numbering is starts, numbering of the track starts from the zero and increases when you move inwards on the platter. This is the sector. The tracks that are divided through these vertical lines. These vertical lines divide the tracks into the sectors. This is the area that comprise a particular sector. This is sector 1, this is sector 2, and so on. So basically a sector is a continuous linear stream of magnetized bits occupying a curved section of a track. Sectors are the smallest physical storage units on a disk. This is the smallest storage unit. Actually, the data that is stored on the disk is stored into the particular sector. Each sector stores a size of 512 bytes of data. And the numbering starts from the outermost track, and it starts with 1. That means first sector will be 1, then 2, then so on. Tracks are numbered from 0. Track 0, track 1, track 2, and so on. So first sector is the sector of track 0. That is outermost track. Cluster. Cluster, it is a combination of one or more contiguous sectors. And the that is actually the smallest piece of storage that an operating system can place into the data into it. The bytes in a cluster varies according to the size of the drive. That means the size of a particular cluster can vary as per the size of the drive that you are using. That means drive to drive, the size of the cluster can vary, and also on the basis of the version of operating system. Different operating systems support different size of the clusters. Some use 512 bytes, some use 1024 bytes, some use 2048 bytes of the sector size. So how do we calculate the capacity of the disk? So it is a very simple method by multiplication of the cylinders with heads and sectors, and all these three are multiplied by the size of the particular sector on the particular disk, that is 512 bytes, for example. So for example, a disk has 12,495 cylinders and 16 heads, read-write heads, and 63 sectors, and each sector is of size 512 bytes. Then we multiply all these cylinders with heads, and that is multiplied by the number of sectors and the size of the sector, that is 512 bytes. Then it leads to the approximate 6 GB of the storage capacity of the disk. So this is how we calculate the disk capacity, by multiplying the number of cylinders available on the disk, the number of heads available on the disk, the number of sectors available on the disk, and the actual size of a single sector will define the total capacity of the disk. So this was all about the physical structure of the disk drive. Now we are discussing about the logical structure of the data disk drive. That means how the actual data is implemented and stored into the disk. So basically we divide the logical structure into five logical terms. First one is master boot record. Then is DOS boot record, DBR, then FAT, file allocation tables, then comes root directory, and then the actual data area. As you can see in the diagram, first block is the MBR, then second block is the DBR, then file allocation tables, FAT1, FAT2, then root directory, and then the actual area, data area, where data is actually stored. So we'll discuss these components one by one. First one is MBR, master boot record. It is sometimes also known as master partition table. It contains a small program to load and start the active partition from the hard disk. It has a small program जिसके through हम क्या करते हैं system के अंदर hard disk के particular partition को क्या करते हैं start करता है और उसको load करवाता है into the system. Then MBR is created on the hard disk by executing fdisk.exe command of DOS if it is not available on the system, like c drive slash fdisk.exe slash MBR. This is how we execute the command. It is located at the absolute sector 0, or we can say at cylinder 0, head 0, and sector 1. That is the first block of the disk drive actually contains the MBR. If we have more than one partition, then there are extended master boot records, EMBRs. That means if suppose we have divided the disk into four partitions, like as you see in the my computer drive C, drive D, drive E, drive F, like this. So see, if there are four sectors, then one will be the MBR on the active partition in which your operating system resides, and rest of the partitions will be having the extended MBR to maintain the information into the those partitions. This is how, if suppose the disk is divided into three partitions, drive C, drive D, and drive E. So first drive will be having MBR, and the second and third will be having EMBR, E for extended MBR 1, extended MBR 2. If further partitions are there, then extended MBR 3, 4, 5, and so on can be there on the system. These are located on the very first blocks of the partition, at the very first part of the partition storage into the disk. So then comes DBR. After the partitioning of the table, the DOS boot record, or sometimes isko hum DOS boot sector bhi bolte hain, it is the second most important information on your hard disk. It actually contains the information about disk geometry, like bytes per sector. Ek sector ke andar kitne bytes hum store kar sakte hain, that is the size of the sector. Then sectors per cluster, एक क्लस्टर के अंदर कितने नंबर ऑफ सेक्टर्स अवेलेबल है. देन रिजर्व्ड सेक्टर्स, व्हाट आर द रिजर्व्ड सेक्टर्स दैट आर यूज्ड बाय द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, दैट आर फॉर यूज ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. डीबीआर इज क्रिएटेड बाय द फॉर्मेट कमांड ऑफ डिस्क. समटाइम्स यू फॉर्मेट द डिस्क टू एम्प्टी द स्पेस इन टू द ड्राइव, and that format command creates the DBR into the storage space of that particular disk. The job of DBR is to load the operating system from the hard disk drive into the main memory. DBR what actually does, aapke operating system jo hai usko wo load karwata hai kahan pe, आपके मेन मेमोरी के अंदर. बिकॉज जब मेन मेमोरी के अंदर आपका ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम आएगा, तब उसके जो कमांड्स हैं, जो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम के जो प्रोग्राम्स हैं, वो एग्जीक्यूट होते हैं और हमारा सिस्टम क्या होता है, लोड होता है, स्टार्ट होता है. फॉर डूइंग दिस डीबीआर कंटेन्स ए स्मॉल प्रोग्राम विच एग्जीक्यूट्स द एमबीआर एग्जीक्यूटेबल प्रोग्राम. तो डीबीआर वो क्या करवाता है, इसके अंदर एक प्रोग्राम है, वो MBR के एग्जीक्यूटेबल जो प्रोग्राम है उसको एग्जीक्यूट करवाता है। और उसके अंदर क्या होता है, जितने भी दोस पार्टीशंस हैं जो कंटेन करते हैं कोड टू बूट द मशीन, मशीन को जो आपका ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम है उसको बूट करने के लिए जो कोड होता है वो उसको क्या करवाता है, वो एग्जीक्यूट करवाता है DBR। जब सारे जो प्रोग्राम लोड होते हैं तो सिस्टम हमारा क्या होता है, स्टार्ट होता है। लेकिन इसके अंदर जो क्या होता है, जो कंट्रोल है, जो कंट्रोल ऑफ द सिस्टम है, दैट इज गिवन टू ओनली द एक्टिव पार्टीशन ऑफ द सिस्टम स्टोरेज डिवाइस, दैट इज द पार्टीशन दैट इज मार्क्ड एज एक्टिव। दैट मीन्स एक्टिव पार्टीशन इज दैट इन विच योर एक्चुअल ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम रिजाइड्स। That partition can have the control of the whole functioning of the operating system or the system, machine. Then comes FAT, File Allocation Table. It was introduced in 1977 to store data and has been modified several times. Modified kis liye? For the changing needs, for the dynamic requirements, for the change in the technologies with the passage of time, we need to update these file allocation tables to hold the latest requirements of the user or the system. So it was developed to fulfill the requirements of fast and flexible system for managing data on both removable and fixed media. If you talk about the removable media, or if you talk about the fixed media that is permanently connected to your system, उसको मैनेज करने के लिए हम क्या यूज करते हैं, फाइल एलोकेशन टेबल्स। तो एक्चुअल व्हाट एक्चुअली डज ए फैट, तो फैट कीप्स ए मैप ऑफ द कंप्लीट सरफेस ऑफ द डिस्क ड्राइव, इट कंटेन्स द कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डिस्क ड्राइव सच दैट विच एरिया इज फ्री, विच एरिया इज टेकन अप बाई विच फाइल, etc. When some data stored on the disk is to be accessed, जब हमें कोई डाटा एक्सेस करना है तो DOS जो होता है तो DOS कंसल्ट करता है FAT के साथ to find out the area of hard disk on which actually that data is stored. So the FAT manages the disk area in a group of sectors called as clusters. तो जो clusters जो हमने बात की थी डिस्क ड्राइव के स्ट्रक्चर के अंदर, वो क्लस्टर्स को कौन मैनेज करता है, फैट मैनेज करता है, फाइल एलोकेशन टेबल। सो बेसिकली द फैट एंट्रीज कैन कंटेन वैल्यूज दैट इंडिकेट, दैट मींस दीज आर द वैल्यूज दैट आर अवेलेबल इन ए फैट फाइल एलोकेशन टेबल। द फर्स्ट वन इज द नेक्स्ट क्लस्टर इन फैट चेन फॉर ए गिवन फाइल, एक फाइल पर्टिकुलर फाइल है उसके लिए नेक्स्ट क्लस्टर कौन सा है जिसके अंदर वो फाइल क्या है, स्टोर्ड है, बिकॉज देयर कैन बी मल्टीपल क्लस्टर्स यूज्ड फॉर ए पर्टिकुलर फाइल टू स्टोर। देन फ्री क्लस्टर्स, कौन कौन से फ्री क्लस्टर है जिनको यूज कर सकते हैं डेटा को स्टोर करने के लिए। देन इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ बैड सेक्टर्स, बैड सेक्टर्स आर दो सेक्टर्स विच आर एक्चुअली डैमेज्ड either physically or logically. So it identifies the clusters containing one or more sectors that are physically damaged, and if they are damaged they cannot be used to store any kind of data. So to avoid that situation they identify the bad sectors. Then the final cluster of a file, that means the if a particular file is stored, then what is the actual final cluster in which the file is stored. So these are the basic entries of a FAT table. If the number is 0, it indicates a free cluster. If the question marks are there, it indicates cluster is in used and next cluster in chain jo bhi hai usko wo display kara hai. Then if the hex code is FF0 to FF6 or FFFF0 to FFFF6, so that means that particular cluster is reserved to be used by operating system only. If it is FF7 or FFFF7 code, That means cluster contains bad sectors. That is, it is not used for data storage. If the, because the cluster is bad, it means there are some damaged parts which will refrain the system to store the data. So these are the bad sectors which cannot be used for storage. And if it is FF8 to FFF or FFF8 to FFFF, if this Xcode is there, it means end of a file. Then comes root directory. The root directory is like a table of contents for the information stored on the hard disk drive. जैसे कि आपकी बुक होती है, बुक के अंदर आपका एक टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट्स होती है पहले स्टार्टिंग में, जिसके थ्रू आप किसी भी कंटेंट के ऊपर नेविगेट कर सकते हो, जंप कर सकते हो, एक्सेस कर सकते हो उसके थ्रू विद द हेल्प ऑफ पेज नंबर्स एंड ऑल. सो जस्ट लाइक दैट रूट डायरेक्टरी इज अ टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट्स फॉर द कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन स्टोर्ड ऑन योर हार्ड डिस्क ड्राइव. द डायरेक्टरी एरिया कीप्स द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द फाइल नेम, इट्स डेट ऑफ क्रिएशन, time of creation, and its the file attributes, size of the file, and the starting cluster of a particular file. The number of files that one can store on the root directory depends on the FAT type being used. That means if a different there are various versions of FAT, if you that varies the number of files that one can store in the root directory. That means the capacity of the root directory varies with the variations in the type of file allocation table used. So this is the list of the limits of root entries for different media and FAT. We were discussing if different FATs file allocation tables are used, then the capacity to store the entries into the root directory are varies. So accordingly, this is a list prepared in which different FATs are used, and according to that, different root directory capacities is there. So for example, if single sided 5:1/4 inch 180k FDD floppy disk drive, it can store a maximum 64 root directory entries. If it is double sided 320k FDD, then also it can store 64 entries. If double sided 360k FDD, then it can store 112, and so on up to the hard drives with FAT32. As it treats the root directory as a file, so it can store 65,536. Then comes data area or the files area. It is the actual area in which your data, the user data, is stored into the system. It is the free space of the disk drive where data can be stored by the user. So the remainder of the volume after root directory is the data area. The data area contains the actual data stored on the disk surface. When we format a hard disk, the format command of the DOS does not destroy or override the data on the data area. The format command only removes the directory entry and FAT entries, file allocation table entries, and it does not even touch the actual data area. This makes the recovery of accidentally formatted hard disk drive. That means we use various recovery tools to recover the data if unfortunately by the system crash or some unknown action, data gets deleted or formatted. So we can recover that data through the various recovery tools available. That only becomes possible because when the data is formatted, when the disk is formatted, then only the root directory and the FAT entries are deleted. Actual data remains intact into the drive. And that's why we are able to recover that data. So this is the summary of the whole content that we have discussed in our tutorial. I hope you find it a very valuable information for your benefit and for your knowledge. If you find any difficulties, you can contact me. And if you find any problem, you can ask me at any time on my contact details that are shown at the start of the video. So this is all for now about the disk structure. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.